First up, this player has the most wins in NBA playoff history. Is it Kobe?
The bronze likeness of Lakers great Magic Johnson that can be found just outside the front door of our location today, the Staples Center. Greetings, everyone. Welcome to 2K Sports and another exciting edition of NBA Basketball. This is Kevin Harlan. We've got Steve Smith and Greg Anthony at the table with me. And the fourth member of our crew, David Aldridge, our sideline reporter. And here's a look at the numbers for Morris.
And he's gone dry over the past 10 games, guys. His scoring is way down, and he can't seem to fight his way out of the slump. He better get it going tonight, or they'll start losing patience with him.
Here are the starters for Brooklyn. Durant plays the four with Allen at center. Spencer Dinwiddie out there with Irving, and it's LeVert in at the three. And for Los Angeles, Ivica Zubac, he's out there with Morris. Then there's Kawhi Leonard. Then it's Paul George, and it's Beverly in at the point guard position. Two good rebounding teams here tonight, Steve. They rely on second chance points.
Yeah, great offensive rebounding teams and teams that can put up second chance opportunities. They control the pace by hitting the glass. So interesting to see who wins that battle.
And Steve, if nothing else, just more shots, right?
Yes.
They'll just take more FGA.
More possessions.
And it's Irving with the ball for the Brooklyn Nets. Here's Dinwiddie. Misses the step back jump shot. Dinwiddie against Leonard. To the middle. Here's Morris. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Kawhi is carving up this defense. Love his awareness. He is finding the open man.
On its way from Irving for two. That one falls, coming off Dinwiddie's feet.
High offensive IQ. He makes great reads and adjustments on the fly.
In the corner, George with it. Off target from three-point range. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin, I was able to talk with Doc Rivers a few minutes ago. We talked about how they'll match up with Caris LeVert. Coach said his slashing ability is what stands out. We've got to keep him in front of us and force him to make perimeter shots. Kevin, back to you.
All right, thank you, David.
Because of the explosiveness, Beverly's dangerous off the dribble, as you see right there.
Durant against Morris, 11 feet away, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up, and the Clippers get called for the foul.
And a one-year player in Texas, Jared Allen, came into the league and is a bit of a project. He's got ample playing time to develop in Brooklyn.
And, Greg, safe to say, Allen's defense is ahead of his offense.
Yeah, but his mobility and leaping ability serve him well as a finisher, providing that vertical spacing teams like to have inside.
Now, here's Beverly. He picked up 15 points in their last win against Golden State. And it's sent back by Allen. And Leonard gets it to go. Now about 2 minutes gone here in the first quarter. George against Dinwiddie. Over George. No good on the shot, a bit long that time.
They are out of rhythm, 1 for 5 so far. You just need to calm down and reward your matchups.
For Los Angeles, they've gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. Bounce pass from Beverly. There's Paul George on the assist by Beverly.
I love the patience Beverly has developed with the ball in his hands. Terrific find.
And the Nets miss again. For Los Angeles, they've gone 4-7 from the field, shooting over 50%. Leonard with the ball, defended by Dinwiddie. Here's Zubac. And the dunk by Zubac.
That's why you never quit battling on the offensive glass.
And that's a nice reward for his effort. The flush, perfect.
Working hard, beating everyone to the ball. He does this night in and night out.
Now, here's George, following the miss by Kyrie Irving. And it's Beverly missing.
Wow, that's one you just kind of assume is going in. Tough luck.
KD passes to LeVert. Over Leonard. And good. And a friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. And it's the Clippers with the ball. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. Free throw line jump shot. That's basket number two with his third shot off to a fast 2 for 3.
They're getting him shots in his spots. That's understanding your personnel.
And with the signing of Durant and Irving along with DeAndre Jordan, Greg, are the Brooklyn Nets now claiming the mantle for the top team in New York?
Listen, they were already the better team a season ago. After stealing the Knicks' thunder in free agency, acquiring the superstar talent, we're poised to steal the Knicks' cultural relevance as well.
And the Clippers decide to take their first time out here. And the 6'6 point guard, Spencer Dinwiddie, second-round pick of the Detroit Pistons in 2014. You know, Greg, they might have wished they held on to him.
One of the most improved players in our league. Last season, he signed that 4-year, $48 million extension from the Nets, rewarding his growth.
A platoon swap here for the Clippers. A big group substitution here for Brooklyn. Jordan, he's checked in for Allen. Chandler comes in for Kevin Durant. Prince is checked in for Caris LeVert. And Joe Harris is subbed in for Spencer Dinwiddie. And a deep three from Irving. And the Nets, another three.
This is what makes Kyrie so dangerous. He is so proficient from distance.
They get a hand on it. Chandler with the steal. Pull-up jumper. Another one falls for Brooklyn. 1:25 left to play in the first quarter. Jackson against Irving. Jackson is doubled. The shot's good by Williams.
That's the leadership they're looking for from Jackson. Staying patient, surveying the court, locates the open man.
And here's Harris from the arc. That one's no good. That makes him 1 for 2.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also are going their way.
On the wing, Irving. He is defended by Hill. Yep, that one goes. 7 points for Kyrie Irving. The Los Angeles Clippers coming to this one after the win against Golden State. Jackson gets to Hill. And there's the call on Montrezl Hill. That is his first foul of the game. For three, Harris. An absolute bomb from three-point range. Harris has got 5 points so far.
They're getting a lot of their points outside the paint. Three of their last five baskets are from three-point range.
In the corner, Shannon with it. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson.
Both teams running perimeter-oriented plays that are working. How often do we see this these days? Clubs answer each other from range.
Two. Another one falls for Brooklyn.
That's the level of concentration you need with a hand in your face. Kyrie getting it done.
And the foul on Joe Harris. That's his first foul. Tries a three off the inbound. And Williams with the basket on the assist by Harris. He's got five.
Both teams racking up the points to start this game. And you wonder how long they can keep it going. At some point, you expect the defense will adjust.
And at the end of one, both teams putting up some points. Clippers lead by one. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. One of the league's best point guards, Kyrie Irving, had this to say about his competition.
In 2011, I came into a league where the point guard position was still being revolutionized, and now guys are solidifying that spot every single year. There are young guys coming in, but now we have established point guards that...
Some say, Greg, a golden age at the point guard position.
Yeah, and Irving right here with the best of them. He embraces the challenge.
It's some good action already in this one, but a fairly even matchup after the first quarter of play. And guys, what's your take on the Clippers so far?
Way to set the table. Offensively, they dominated on the interior. They came in looking to attack from the get-go, willing to be physical and setting the tone.
We've got Jermichael Green, Reggie Jackson out there with Williams. Then it's Montrezl Harrell, and it's Shamet in at the three. They're the group out there for the Clippers starting the second quarter.
We see his playmaking ability each year has been growing and growing. Beautiful play by Kyrie.
Williams kicks to Green. He dishes it to Jackson. Green again, Irving. Outside Williams, just five on the clock. From deep three-point range, no good on that one. The Nets go the other way with it. And this is the first season matchup for them against this Clippers team.
And they put up a goose egg last year when they played this team twice.
Well, Smitty, the game is evolving. We know that. New moves and techniques developed. Talk about some that have grown in popularity since the time of your retirement to now.
You know, the step back is one, and then also the step back is one. The Euro step, and I think also guys right now being able to launch their bodies into guys. I don't want to say it's a move, but that's how guys are playing. Because you can't hand check, guys are throwing their body into the defender on the move even more.
Kawhi Leonard checked in for Jermichael Green. And then for Brooklyn, Kevin Durant comes in for Wilson Chandler. And Spencer Dinwiddie subbed in for Irving. Jackson from long range. DeAndre Jordan grabs the miss. For Brooklyn, they've gone 3-4 from the floor here in the second quarter. Durant, he's off on that one. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. Following this one, they get to host the Pelicans. And that will be the middle game of this three-game homestand. And Leonard gets it to go. Leonard's got it all tied up now for Los Angeles.
The power, the length, the ability to finish. Leonard dominant in that painted area.
Here's Dinwiddie. This is the three. LA has gone 0-2 from deep in the zone. Leonard dishes to Jackson. He gets that one. And the Clippers lead by two.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Here's Harris, the 15-footer. Good. Harris has got 9 points.
I like this. I really do. He recognizes the mismatch, simply rises up and fires.
Los Angeles calls timeout. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
Yeah, it was all hands on deck. Helps to get points off the bench when you're on the road.
It was a total team effort in terms of passing the baton to the guy that's hot.
Here's what the Clippers are going with right now. Morris is checked in for Landry Shamet. Paul George comes in for Lou Williams. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Reggie Jackson. Allen's checked in for the Nets. Caris LeVert comes in for Torian Prince. KD, that's for two. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Here in the second quarter, about 3 minutes played, a superstar summer Greg for the Los Angeles Clippers in Kawhi Leonard and in Paul George. Greg, they have two elite wings, great defenders in their prime.
Give them credit, but also Kawhi Leonard pushing the levers behind the scenes. He wanted another superstar to join him in recruiting Paul George, who still had 2 years left on his deal in OKC. Kawhi took unprecedented control of his free agent destiny.
Okay, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, Kenny Atkinson, who's a native of Long Island, now has his dream job, coaching the Brooklyn Nets. He doesn't need praise or recognition. Instead, he's fueled by the fear of failure. He says, I always feel like I'm one banana peel away from never being in the NBA again. Kevin, he's got his team playing with that same determination.
David, he sure does. Thank you very much. Zubac is checked in for the Clippers. Outside, George from downtown does not find the basket. His third miss. He's made just one so far. Releases. And Dinwiddie gets it to go. On the answers by Allen. Now it's a 6-point Nets lead. And there's the pass to Morris. the bucket for two. Morris has got six.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
A nice shot by LeVert.
Love the assist. I mean, he knew exactly where that bounce pass had to be to create that opportunity.
Bounce pass from Beverly. Here's Morris. That one goes in for him too, making it look easy. He's now 4 for 4.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
Nets leading by 5. And here's Harris from the arc. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
And so Beverly will bring it up for Los Angeles. And there's the call. It's on Spencer Dinwiddie. That's his first foul. And the Clippers making a switch here. Green's checked in. Then, for the Nets, Chandler comes in for Joe Harris. And Irving subbed in for Dinwiddie. Beverly against Irving. Pass to Zubats.
His second foul in as many quarters. We'll see if he backs off or stays aggressive.
Well, if it's a Zubats, may not block a lot of shots, but steady, he is still a solid defender.
What Zubats does is a great job of challenging players at the rim and provides great help from the weak side. He does rack up a lot of defensive fouls, but hopefully that decreases with time.
Chandler, he is holding by Zubats. Zubats has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. 10 points for Marcus Morris.
And the feed from George couldn't be better. The timing, the placement, everything about that dish was pinpoint.
Irving passes to Allen. Now Chandler. Now 8 seconds separate the two clocks. Over Green. They get it back. And staying with the play, Irving. And the Nets lead by 6.
You know we talk about it all the time, guys. Those second chance buckets are always the result of that extra effort.
The Clippers shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight.
Take a break. Take a break.
Two shots. And he knocks down the first one. And George drops them both.
We've seen him put a lot of pressure on the defense and then cash in at the line.
LeVert inside the line. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. LeVert's got 5 points now in the quarter. George looking around. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. And so it's Brooklyn with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. Their lead is where it is because they've gotten good shot.
Thanks a lot. Kyrie, what were you all focusing on coming into the game tonight?
I come out with an intense focus and intensity that other teams can't match. Just doing whatever it takes to keep our tempo. Guys are in a great rhythm when we have a great tempo, so just trying to get everybody involved and do whatever it takes to win.
Thank you, David, for that interview, and we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. That was a comfort. Brooklyn found themselves in a close game in the first. They were unable to ever build a big lead in the first period, with 3 points being their largest cushion. They really touched on the right formula in the second quarter, as they were able to pull out to a 6-point lead before the halftime break. And from what we saw so far from the Nets, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
Well, I love the way they're pushing the tempo, beating the defense down the floor, filling the lanes, finishing with authority early, getting to the rim, and finishing hard.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Clippers?
Well, as we know, it's always a good idea to pound the ball for the paint. So many defensive game plans are focused just on stopping the three. When you hurt a team down low, they got to react. That allows you to play inside out. Trust me, I have a good game. I just keep it inside, keep the back.
And that's a wrap. With the third quarter approaching, we now send you back to Kevin and... We'll be right back.
got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. We've seen a tremendous game from Harris.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him, really staying focused on quality shots. And many of those quality shots have been jumpers, a very high percentage of those in the first half. A big key to the Clippers' recent surge, the development of Montrezl Harrell. His activity and his ability to score have been infectious for this team, and he also can be very intimidating.
Checking out the group for Kenny Atkinson to start the second half. Durant plays the four with Allen at center. Spencer Dinwiddie out there with Irving, and it's LeVert in at the small forward. Leonard against LeVert. Passes to Beverly. Morris outside. Six on the shot clock. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. Dinwiddie with the rebound. And the Clippers getting Harrell in that Chris Paul deal. Turned out to be a decent trade for both teams.
You're totally right. The Rockets already had Capella. Harrell was sort of a redundant in terms of skill set. And you can only have one rim runner on the floor before you began to compromise spacing.
And here is Los Angeles now. 8-point game. Pass to Zubats. Beverly against Irving. Morris right side. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's 86%.
And I like the different looks that Morris can give you. Inside, outside, and in transition.
And here's George. He'll bring it up for Los Angeles. Beverly with the ball. He's picked up by Irving. And Leonard gets it to go.
Really crisp, intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
And on the way from Irving for three. That one falls coming off Dinwiddie's feet. Dinwiddie's got four assists in the game. Dinwiddie with the steal. Allen inside the three-point line. Again, the Nets for two.
You know, I didn't find a very good shot on that possession, but still able to get 2 points.
Feeds to George. Outside left. It's up a three. Allen with the rebound. Allen's got four rebounds in this game.
Many thought the Raptors or Lakers would land Kawhi, but in the end, he came to the Clippers to write his own legacy. Returning to Southern Cal, where he grew up, was a big part of his decisions. A big surprise was how Kawhi was out recruiting other stars behind the scenes to join him with the Clippers.
Irving kicks to Durant. On deep, the long distance three is buried. Durant's got the lead up to nine now for Brooklyn.
You better start picking him up at half court. KD is that kind of shooter.
Timeout. Los Angeles calls timeout. So many NBA players now have their talented children playing in the NBA or in college and will soon be in the NBA. Smitty, whose kids stand out to you as potential superstars?
Hey, Kevin, Dale Curry for sure.
No, wait. Okay, I could have gotten that one. Steph Curry. Who else catches your eye?
I think up and coming, LeBron's kid, Shaq's son, D-Wade's. And that's what you love. You see a lot of these guys, and it's great for me. I remember when they were little, Kevin, and now seeing them winning championships, being able to play on that stage is unbelievable.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Harrell, he's checked in for Zubats. Andrew Shamet comes in for George. And Reggie Jackson subbed in for Patrick Beverly. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, we know about Lou Williams' story. The three-time sixth man of the year may be undersized, but he keeps finding angles to score. Williams said, "I can't shoot straight up. I've always played crooked. It's weird, but it's something I've developed, fading away from guys. I have bigger defenders on me, and it's just about creating space." Kevin, even well into his 30s, Lou Will still does it as well as anybody.
I would totally agree, David. He is always dead. Thank you. Williams, he's checked in for Morris.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm. Empty possession, and you don't want to miss these easy looks.
on the wing, Jackson, from outside the arc, and he's good on the three ball. Now it's just a 4-point Nets lead.
Nice play. Usually, Reggie prefers to initiate, but this time gets it done off the catch.
And the whistle blows on the backcourt violation. He went over and back. Jermichael Green, he's checked in for Leonard. Now here's Jackson. 5 points in the game. To the paint. And it's Green with the jam.
But what about the athletic ability of Green? A real powerhouse who just knows how to bring the hammer down.
On its way from Irving for two. And again, no good by Brooklyn. Los Angeles has gone into the three-point range 4 times since halftime and buried 2 of them. Just the kind of play they need in a game this close. You know, that's the kind of aggression they want from their floor leader.
But not every point guard can give you that, the ability to finish with that level of authority.
Working against size, he's just crafty enough to carve out some wiggle room.
And that's tough to do from the mid-range because help can come from anywhere, but he beats everyone to the punch.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block. No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going in this quarter. Williams can't hit. The Nets have gotten 6 of their 12 shots to drop for him here in the second half so far. Here's Allen. The top of the key jumper is on the mark. Allen's got 6. The Clippers trail. And there's the call on Kyrie Irving. That's foul number 2 for him. Leonard, he's checked in for the Clippers. Then for the Nets, DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Allen. And Wilson Chandler's subbed in for Dinwiddie. Jackson finds Leonard. Here's Harrell. He's guarded by Chandler. And it's blocked by Jordan.
DeAndre is simply one of the most electrifying shot blockers in the game. If you put up a shot around him, you better put it up high.
Shot from the inbound. Chalk up 2 there. Jackson's got the game tied up here for Los Angeles.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket coming off a brick pass.
And so it's Leonard with it. He'll bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. And Harrell slams it in.
I mean, a dunk machine dating back to high school. Montrezl Harrell is an absolute monster around the rim.
They get it back. Here's Jordan. Banked in off the glass.
His hard work on the backboard really just has given them more opportunities to score.
Now Leonard, 13 points in the game. This is his first free throw of the game.
And to look at his percentage from the line, you see him at 89%. That's an indicator of what a consistent stroke he has.
Kawhi was drafted 15th overall in 2011. If they had a redraft, I wonder what number he would go down.
KD can't get it to go. From deep three-point range, no good on the last second attempt there. Kawhi Leonard has been on display for the L.A. Clippers. He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific basketball instinct on display. Right back after this break. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, you also have the location of the pass. Puts it right where it needs to be, where his man can do something with it.
Well, this has been a great contest so far, and I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. A moment now to reset the lights. Brought to us by Gatorade. All fueled up here for the fourth quarter. Taking a look at Los Angeles. We're down low with 4 with Harrell in the middle. Beverly and Williams, the guard chamber. And it's George at the 3. LeVert inside the line. Off target on the outside leader.
And see, he had his momentum going forward, but really didn't need to lean in there. He was wide open.
Hasn't been able to dial it in from distance. He has just the 1 3, and that was in the first half.
It doesn't go for him. So the Clippers will take it the other way. And there's the call on Durant. That'll be his second foul of the game. Los Angeles making a switch here. Morris is checked in. KD against Leonard. Out to the right wing. And here's Harrell. And stolen by Jordan. Fires the three. Goes back up. And he banks in the layup.
One of the great rebounders in this league. When Jordan does score, this is often how it happens.
Everly with the ball. And there's the call on Durant. That's his third foul of the game. Zubac is checked in for Harrell. And the Nets also making a change. Dinwiddie is checked in. Morris finds Beverly. Over in the corner, Zubac. And the pass to Morris. Five on the clock. Brooklyn with the rebound. Durant's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Here's Jordan. Second chance effort, Irving. Score of the basket, his eighth. 8 for 13 from the floor.
You have to love the imagination of Kyrie, able to get off his shot in traffic.
Beverly looking around. Here's Leonard. And again, it's the Clippers missing.
No one on him. He committed to fading away. Probably could have taken more time with that shot.
Durant, that's good.
How do you stop that? You have to play KD for the drive, but then he just rises up like that, and there's nothing you can do to stop him.
And the Clippers call time here. And at this point of the game, getting a break here, important for the teams to regroup, and for the players, this is where you have a chance to get rehydrated with Gatorade, get ready to play strong to finish off the game. Up with our sideline reporter, David Olden.
Well, during that last break, Kevin, I got a chance to hear what Doc Rivers said to his team. He told his guys the inside game is working, so stick with it. That means posting, slashing, getting to the rim, whatever produces these high percentage looks. Kevin, back to you.
Thank you, David.
Careless turnover. You lose focus for even a moment in this league. That's the result.
That's leading by three. And on the way from Irving for three, the offensive rebound, LeVert tries again. No good on the layup.
Needing right at the rim. He typically converts in those situations. Not this time.
And again, no good by the Clippers. The Nets have gotten away three of their nine field goal attempts to go down since the end of the third. Pretty cold down the stretch. Here's Durant. And that one is off. And so George will bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Here's Leonard. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
I mean, those huge hands of Kawhi Leonard give him great control of the ball. Very sparing with his turnovers.
And Brooklyn making a change. Allen's checked in. And for Kawhi, he never seems like he's forcing the issue offensively.
I mean, he has studied the post games of Michael Jordan, and being able to score at all three levels has made the game easy. With his strength and his turnaround jumper, he can get his shot off with ease.
And the open shot for Morris. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Morris. Brooklyn leading by three. Paul George with the steal. 16 feet away. Second shot opportunity. And it's sent back by Allen. And here we go. The fans break with Dinwiddie. Over George. And good. Got the angles that time as it falls. And 11 points for Spencer Dinwiddie. LA's gotten off to an 0 for 2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Miss again, and here are the Nets. They're on a 10-2 run here. Allen inside the 3-point line. It's hauled in by the Clippers. And now
now the Clippers on the break. Leonard with the ball. Guarded down by Durant. And that one's good. Beverly.
Beverly plays with a scorer's mentality. Takes the opportunity to step up.
Here's Allen. It's hold in by Beverly. I guess even he has to miss one of those. That's a good one. Down low. Morris. And Morris pulls it down. As we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thank you, Kevin. DeAndre, where did you try to make the most impact tonight?
Just trying to limit those guys to one shot. They have a really big team, so keeping them off the board. But, you know, setting screens and rolling, putting pressure on those guys. Our guys are shooting back.